Hey y'all, we're out here fishing in the pond at our place, and big whopper here, but we're having a lot of fun. We caught 7 or 8 little bass already playing around with the top water. I'm gonna put him back in, but I've got a spinner bait on, caught with a little old H&H you can see here, caught a few bass on that. My wife's been tearing them up. I'm the official hook getter offer. I take the fish off the hook, so I'm busy, but she's just got a little top water here. And you can see in our tackle box, there's some rooster tails. We're not big fishermen. We just have fun fishing in the pond. Top waters, perch hooks. Got a little bitty top water down here. All kinds of different bait. And I think about we as Christians, our job, Jesus said, we are going to be fishers of men. He said, follow me and I'll make you fishers of men. So when I go fishing, I think about how the church should be as Christians. And obviously there's all different kinds of bait for fishing. I talk about that a lot, but you see it in a tackle box. We tried different baits here and different times of the day. Usually a top water works early and late in the evening, but we've actually hit a few here on top waters as well as a spinner bait. So I just want to encourage you. You know, our times are a little challenging, but people, I believe that the positive, I'm always looking for something positive, and I believe that people are more receptive to a message of hope than ever before. And if we've ever needed Jesus to be our Lord and Savior and our anchor and our peace and our strength, I mean, what better time than right now? So I just encourage you to keep your, you'll never catch a fish unless you wet a hook. We've caught several fish here in just about 30 minutes. But I can promise you, had we not threw the bait out there and reeled it in and wet it, got our hook and line wet, we would have never caught a fish. We could have paddled around in the boat in circles and said, well, we didn't catch anything. But if we told you that we didn't put our rod and reel and throw the bait in, you'd say, well, man, you've lost your mind. What do you expect? The same way with us. It's always be sharing our faith. And I know in my life, many years I've been able to reach people, but it takes different bait for different people. So I just wanted to encourage you. Jesus said we are fishers of men, and even in the times we're in right now, you know what? It's a perfect opportunity. The fields are ripe for harvest, so let people know about our live service. Let them know about the Jesus that lives in your heart personally first, but there's a lot of ways we can plant some seed. I'm going to give y'all one last little illustration. So I'm going to get her to pan the camera over towards the pond. The wind's picked up just since we've been here doing this video. The wind's picked up on us, so now we'll go back over here. And I've been paddling this boat. It was funny. Allison said, go over to the other side of the lake. And man, I was like, yeah, that's good, but it's a pretty good workout. So here I am paddling. A couple of things with this video, I was telling her, the front of the boat is shaped to paddle, so I'm actually going backwards, which makes my job a lot harder because I'm trying to go backwards. The boat's got it's a flat surface there, whereas the other side, it would be a lot easier to paddle. But I'm going to do this because sometimes we do this in our life. We go the hard way, and so my encouragement to us is, let's don't paddle, you know, the wrong way, just like I'm doing in this boat, kind of as an illustration. But there's two messages here because I can't see where I'm going. But Allison, when I was paddling a while ago, I can't see where I'm going at all. But she was saying, hey, that's good. You're going the right way. You're going towards the still water. So if you look behind me, the water is going to get a little stiller. The wind's coming out of the southeast. And the pond dam is kind of blocking some of that wind. So the closer I get to that pond dam, you can tell the water's really rough back there because it's taking the wind. But up here it's still, and the water's almost like glass even though the wind's blowing. So when I see stuff like this, I always see sermons in everyday life. Number one, I can't see where I'm going, but Allison is helping me, guide me where I need to go. Same way with us, we need to make sure that we take the time to let the Lord guide us and lead us. And Psalm says that he will lead us beside what kind of water? Still water. Psalms, the book of Psalms, David said, he leads me beside still water. So now, here we are, through Allison's guidance, we're over here on still water. So I just pray that you'd continue to let the shepherd lead and guide you. When the storms and our winds and the seas get wavy, Jesus still has a spot for you where the waters are still. We can have peace like a river. So, hey, God bless y'all. I'm looking forward to tomorrow. We'll see y'all in the morning. Don't forget, be fishers of men. Let your light shine. Tell as many people you can about our services. Unchurched people, encourage them. And share your love of Jesus and what he's done for you, because we all have a great testimony. We love you guys. We'll see you in the morning. God bless y'all.